Hello and Namaste. Welcome to Hasera Permaculture Learning Center. In today's video, we are going to walk you through a process of making jam at home from your fresh fruits. And the fruit of our pick for today's video is plum. Though the video is about plum, we can use any kind of fruits and follow the same process to make the jam. The first step is picking the fruits. And while doing so, we have to make sure that we pick the right fruits only. The sweetness of the fresh fruits determine the natural sweetness and sourness in the jam. So we pick fruits of our desired taste. So once the picking is finished, we again screen them for the unripe ones or the unusable ones. And after it's done, we clean the fruits properly in the running water and we are good to go. So another important step to decide is whether we want to put the cover in or not. We can choose to remove the cover as well. The thing that we need to know is when we use the cover, the jam becomes a little bit bitter. So if bitter is not your taste, then we advise you to remove the cover. The method used for peeling might be different in different fruits. If we are using apples, we can simply use a peeler to peel the cover off. And here, when we are using plum and if the fruits are ripe, the cover comes off naturally and it's not much of a problem. So we have to make sure what kind of fruit we are using and the kind of cover it has. And the next step is removing the seeds, and for this we can simply remove the seeds by squeezing the plum with our hands, or if we are using apple, we can cut the apple out and throw the seeds out. And depending on the fruit, after taking the seeds out, we may have to blend the fruit to make it ready to cook. So to cook, as far as we have tried, it's better to use pots made out of steel. If we use pots with iron or copper or aluminium while cooking, the portion of the pot burns and sticks to the jam, which is not good for the long-term storability of the jam. So in our practice, we have found the steel pots to be best when you want to store the jam for long term. And another important thing to note is while cooking, we have to stir it continuously, and if not done so, the lower portion of the jam sticks into the pot and it burns with the fire, and the jam will have burnt taste and unevenly cooked as well. So as far as possible, try to stir it continuously. After cooking for around 1 hour, the volume becomes half, and at this time we are ready to add sugar. And here, for 5 kg of fresh fruit, we add around 1 kg of sugar. With this, the taste of the jam will be a mixture of sweet and sour, but if you want it all sweet, it is better to add more sugar depending on your taste. But if you want to keep the jam stored for a long time, we know that sugar is also used as a preservative in many foods. We recommend you to use almost half sugar, that is, for 5 kg of jam, we use 2.5 kg of sugar. So after the cooking is finished, we let it cool down for around 30 minutes. And in this time, we make our bottles ready to fill. And when you are storing the jam for a long time, glass bottles are good. These bottles should be cleaned and sun-dried properly before filling the jam. Thank you for watching our video. We hope you liked it. And enjoy making jam with your family. Thank you.